The Church of God, and we want to just recognize how wonderful and how good and how great our Heavenly Father is, and that He keeps our promises. He answers our prayers. It's wonderful. So let us pray. And this morning, this Sunday morning, it's just awesome to give God praise at all times. Father God, I thank you so much for this day. I thank you so much, Lord God, for answering every prayer, Lord God, every petition, every request. We ask, Lord God, that you continue to bless this day, Lord God, that you have made. We thank you, Lord God, for allowing the hour to go back in time, Lord God. We've fallen back in time. You've given us an extra hour of rest, Lord God. We just thank you so much, Father, that we worship you, Lord God, this Sunday morning service, and we bless your holy name. I pray for those, Lord God, that are in bereavement, Lord God, and we pray right now for the Maddox family with the loss of, he's no longer with us, but the angels are rejoicing for a soul, that soldier that has gone home to glory. Apostle Ernest Maddox, Father, Apostle Dr. Ernest Maddox, I pray, Lord God, for his wife, Evangelist Barbara Maddox, Lord God, and his church, his ministry, all those that are in bereavement because of the passing of the apostle. We thank you, Lord God, for this day. We bless your holy name. Just heal them, Lord God, as they remember the good times and the knowledge that he rendered unto them and the wisdom that came from you, Lord God, through his writings, his radio broadcast, and his television ministry as well. We thank you, Lord God, and bless your holy name. In Jesus' name, angels of God, just command this airway, command this radio broadcast, this television ministry, as we move forward in the mighty name of Jesus, glorifying God. Protect the communication line in the name of Jesus, I pray. Hallelujah. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit, we want to welcome you into the broadcast now. that you will lead and guide, rule and super rule, as we minister the word of God through God's holy word. In Jesus' precious holy name and through his blood, we pray and we give you praise, Lord God. Amen and amen. All right. Just wanted to look at 2 Chronicles chapter 6 and chapter 1. I'm going to read briefly chapter 6 verse 16. This is a prayer of King Solomon, and as he dedicated the temple that he built, his father gave him all the resources, left it to his son to build, and he obeyed his father's voice. He built the temple, this building, the house of God. Now therefore, O Lord God of Israel, keep with thy servant David, my father, that which thou hast promised him, saying, there shall not fail thee a man in my sight to sit upon the throne of Israel, yet so that thy children take heed to their ways, to walk in my law, as thou hast walked before me. Now then, O Lord God of Israel, let thy words be verified, which thou hast spoken unto thy servant David. But will God indeed dwell with man on earth? Behold, heavens and the heavens of heavens cannot contain thee. How much less this house which thou hast built, which I have built. Have respect, therefore, to the prayer of thy servant and to his supplication, O Lord my God, to hearken unto the cry and the prayer which thy servant prayed before thee, that thine eyes may be open upon this house day and night, and upon the place whereof thou hast said that thou wouldest put thy name there, to hearken unto the prayers which the servant, thy servant prayed towards this place. Hearken therefore unto the supplication of thy servants and of thy people Israel, which they shall make towards this place. Hear thou from thy dwelling place, even from heaven, and when thou hearest, forgive. Amen. If a man sin against his neighbor, amen, and has aught and has made an oath by laid upon him to make him swear, and the oath come before thy altar in this house, then hear thou from heaven and do and judge thy servants by requiting the wicked, by recompensing his way upon his own head, and by justifying the righteous, by giving him according to his righteousness. And if thy people Israel be put to the worse before the enemies because they have sinned against thee, and shall return and confess thy name and pray and make supplication before thee in this house, then hear thou from the heavens and forgive the sin of thy people Israel, and bring them again unto the land which thou givest to them and to their fathers. Amen. The prayer continues all the way until verse 42. Really, really love this prayer. The last verse, verse 42, says, O Lord God, turn not away the face of thine anointed. Remember the mercies of David, thy servant. I love how King Solomon always referred back to his father, David. Because David was an honorable man, one that served God. Amen. So I want to bless the reading of God's holy word. We read this in its entirety on last night's broadcast, but I want you to take your time, if you didn't hear it, to read and study this prayer, powerful prayer. Again, it's found 2 Chronicles chapter 6, verses 16 through 42 is the entire prayer. Now, turn your attention to 2 Chronicles chapter 1, and I'm going to read a little more about how Solomon became so anointed and so wealthy. Here it says, "And Solomon, the son of David, was strengthened in his kingdom, and the Lord his God was with him and magnified him exceedingly. Then Solomon spake unto all Israel, to the captains of thousands and of hundreds, and to the judges, and to every governor in all Israel, and the chief of his fathers." Amen. 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 Solomon would always listen to God. He would always talk to his people. You know, he never went about doing things on his own. That was the beginning of his reign. Anyway, later on in life, he kind of started listening to the voices of other people. But when he got older, but he always listened to God, and he always followed the example of his father, and he always referenced his father David, reminded God about how his father was promised by God for such and such and such. You know, so verse 3 says, "So Solomon, all the congregation with him, went to the high place that was at Gibeon, for there was the tabernacle of the congregation of God, which Moses, the servant of the Lord, had made in the wilderness. But the ark of God and David brought up from Kirjathjearim to the place which David had prepared for it, for he had pitched a tent for it at Jerusalem. Moreover, the brazen altar that Berzael, the son of Uriah, the son of Ur, had made, he put before the tabernacle of the Lord, and Solomon and the congregation saw it unto it. And Solomon went up thither to the brazen altar before the Lord, which was at the tabernacle of the congregation, and offered 1,000 burnt offering upon it. In that night did God appear unto Solomon, and said unto him, Ask what I shall give thee. And Solomon said unto God, Thou hast showed great mercies unto David my father, and hast made me to reign in his stead. Now, O Lord God, let thy promise unto David my father be established, for thou hast made me king over a people like the dust of the earth in multitude. Give me now wisdom and knowledge, that I may go out and come in before this people. For who can judge this thy people that is so great? And God said to Solomon, Because this was in thine heart, and thou hast not asked for riches, wealth, or honor, amen, nor the life of thine enemies, neither yet has asked for long life, but has asked for wisdom and knowledge for thyself, that thou mayest judge my people over whom I have made thee king. Wisdom and knowledge is granted unto thee, and I will give thee riches and wealth and honor, such as none of the kings have had that have been before thee, neither shall there any after thee have the like. Then Solomon came from his journey to the high place that was at Gishon to Jerusalem from before the tabernacle of the congregation, and he reigned over Israel. Solomon gathered the chariots and the horsemen, and he had 1,400 chariots, 12,000 horsemen, which he had placed in the chariot cities and with the king of at Jerusalem, and the king made silver and